Hey everyone. We are asked to provide the ground state electron configuration of aluminum in the standard and noble gas notations. I recommend you take a minute now and try to solve this problem on your own before we go through the answer together. When finding the electron configuration of an atom, we are being asked where does that atom place its electrons, i.e. what shells and orbitals are its electrons most likely to be found in. So, to solve this, the first thing we need to do is look at our periodic table. And we're going to look at how many electrons an aluminum atom actually has in its ground or unexcited state. Looking this up, we can see that aluminum is number 13 on the periodic table, meaning that in a neutral state, no positive or negative charge, our aluminum atom will have 13 protons in its nucleus and thus 13 electrons surrounding that nucleus to maintain the neutral charge. Let's also remember that in the past video, we talked about this handy device for remembering which orbitals have the lowest energy, as those are the orbitals that are going to get filled first. As I believe it makes things easier, I wrote the Bohr model of aluminum here that will help us keep track of our 13 electrons as we place them into our electron energy level diagram. So, let's start by placing our electrons from the lowest energy state to the highest energy state, as shown by our diagram above. We always begin with 1s. As we discussed before, it is our lowest energy shell. And with the s subshell, it can hold 2 electrons. So this leaves us with 11 electrons left. Next, following our arrows, we have 2s, which again can take 2 electrons. Then we have 2p subshells, and these 2p subshells can hold 6 electrons, leaving us with 3 remaining electrons. Continuing down our diagram from above, we can see that we have 3s and then 3p. Filling the s orbital with 2 electrons, we are left with a single remaining electron. This electron can be placed into any 3 of the 3p subshells. All these 3 positions, or orientations if you will, are all equivalent energy states, and therefore it doesn't matter which one gets the electron. Now that we have placed all of our electrons into the energy level diagram, we can write out our electron configurations. Firstly, in standard notation, we have 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, and 3p1. Secondly, let's write out our noble gas notation. The noble gas that is the next lowest to aluminum is neon. Therefore, we can consolidate this portion of the standard notation and write aluminum electron configuration as neon 3s2 3p1. And there we go. We have just solved for aluminum's ground state electron configuration in the standard and noble gas notations. I hope that this video helped your understanding of how to solve for aluminum's ground state electron configuration. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.